All right. So yeah, essentially what I'm gonna teach you is same thing I have teach to Latiny, to Bellopium, to Schmaxi. And that is covering some basics about, well, acrobatics, like some basic acrobatic moves and some of their properties. Then after that, we're gonna talk a bit about knives and how they work. And finally, we're gonna talk a bit about time fees and the interaction of smoke bomb and a few of the other abilities, like how do they work together and why should you use certain abilities at least in some moments of the game. So all right, let's start with it. I'll cover that in a little bit. First I'll cover what I call an instant drop. So basically an instant drop is this: when you're hanging from the ledge like this, no, that's a different thing. That what you're just doing right now. I don't remember the name of this, but yeah, like it's like you drop when you're climbing before you reach the top. To do that, what you have to do is try to climb the wall and press the circle on PlayStation, which is the stun. No, not the stun. The gentle push button. So yeah, if you press the gentle push button, which is a circle on PlayStation, while climbing a wall, it does that. Now another move is then the instant drop, which is this Vanarai. You climb up the wall. Yes, yeah, it seems you already knew how to do this. And the thing about the instant drop is that it has a certain property, which is that you are invulnerable to stuns when you do this. So for example, I want you to get over here. Well, you can just stay at the top. Stay at the top. And no, let me lock you. Let me lock you as my target. Now I want you to mash the square button, which is the kill button. No, stay on top. Stay on top. Do not drop. Smash. Yeah, smash it. I want you to smash it so you can see that you cannot stun me when I do this, because this move is invulnerable to stuns. So that is the whole point. You cannot stun people when they do this. Now the thing about it is that alright, don't press it. The thing about it is that you cannot only do it when you're on the ledge, but you can also like use it while jumping like this. Yeah, so this is useful in the sense that you can avoid like abilities by doing this. Say your target is in one of these ledges, you can get an easy grab kill by doing an instant drop and possibly evading some of their abilities, namely a smoke bomb or I don't know, maybe a knife in some cases. So yeah, it's a pretty tricky move that can be useful in many cases. You can also even do it while wall ejecting, like from one wall to the other. If by any reason you reach the top of the ledge, for example, like this, let me show you what I mean. Say for example, if I'm hanging from here, oh shit, I need to, yeah. So look at this. If I wall eject to the side from here, I'm gonna land on the top of the ledge to my left, like this. Well, actually, I landed below. Let me see if I can land on top. Yeah, okay, like this. If I am here and I wall eject to the side, I'm gonna land like this. So I can do an instant drop there as well by wall ejecting into the side and grabbing the ledge. I'm failing at it though, miserably. But yeah, you can actually do that. Let me see if I can get it at least once. Ah, yeah, I can do it from here, I guess. From this side, it's easier. Oh wow, why am I not grabbing it? Doesn't make any sense. So yeah, you can do that. You can wall eject to the side and land into one of those things. Or like, let me see, I think, yeah, like here, you can do it here as well. For example, you hang from here, you wall eject into the pole that is behind me. Shit, I need to grab. Yeah, and you can instant drop. Okay, not if. Yeah, that's actually a good note. If somebody else hangs from the place where you are going to hang from with your drop, you cannot hang, obviously. So, because there's someone already there. Yeah. Oh, no, don't do that. Why did you do that? Why you? Alright. Come back to me. I will. So, okay, so that's about instant drops. There's something else I want to teach you about acrobatics. Get over here so I can show you. So when you go, when you climb a ledge, you can go into two kinds of acrobatic grab kill positions. This is the first type of position. I call it feet on the wall. So essentially, when you climb and you have your feet on the wall like this, you have a few options and also a few limitations. The option that you have that you don't have otherwise is that you can wall eject because your feet are against the wall. So if your feet are against the wall, you can wall eject from the wall. That is a wall eject, right? Now, the other position that is possible is feet in the air, like this. Get over here. If you climb into a position like this, your feet are going to be in the air, and thus your options for wall eject are gone. You cannot wall eject from this position. But there is also an advantage to this position as well, which I'll describe now. Now back to feet on the wall. If you're in a feet on the wall position, if you climb and go into this position, if you're mashing the kill button while trying to kill your target, you will get an acrobatic kill instead of a grab kill. And you always want to get a grab kill, not an acrobatic kill, because a grab kill is obviously rarer and it is worth more. So yeah, actually you do it. I'll let you do it. So the thing is, if you're hanging already and you press square, you're always gonna get a grab kill. But if you just climb from the bottom and you are mashing the kill button, you're gonna get an acrobatic instead of a grab. Try doing that. I want you to get the acrobatic now. No, get the acrobatic, please. So yeah, try getting the acrobatic. What are you doing, Vanarai? Yeah, like. Oh, I am. Why did you release? I had released before. Okay, so yeah, get it. Yeah. So when you, yeah, I know you say that's obvious, but it's not so obvious to people who are new to the game. And it certainly won't be obvious when I explain the next point. Now do it by waiting a little bit and getting the grab kill instead. I want you to get the grab kill this time. So yeah, please do that. Yeah. I actually couldn't move the camera very well to focus on you, so. But it's fine, I think people got the idea. If you climb the ledge and you wait even just a little bit, you'll get a grab kill. Whereas if you do mash while you're climbing, you're gonna get an acrobatic instead. That's for the simple reason that when you are just climbing, your bonus is an acrobatic, and you can even see it. For example, if you climb like this, actually I have to lock someone so that it becomes visible. Yeah, alright, so I got a target now. If I climb this, while I am climbing and until I hang, well, actually I have to lock you, Vanarai. Please go to the top so I can have you as my target on the top and the change is visible. So for example, if I climb like this, all the way until I get to the top, it is visible that I have the acrobatic bonus, which is 1.5. But after I wait a little bit at the top, it can be seen that it changes to the grab kill, which is times 3. So yeah, you have to wait a bit until it changes. But over time, you just get the timing right about how much you have to wait for the grab. Now, what I wanted to say about the feet in the air position is that feet in the air doesn't have this limitation. When you go into feet in the air position, you can be mashing the square, and as soon as you get to the top, you will always get a grab kill regardless. And I want you to do that, Vanarai. I want you to come from the bottom and climb, mashing full speed the kill button, and you're still gonna get a grab kill. Yeah, sorry, I have to release. My bad. That was my bad. Alright, do it. Yes. So... yeah, that's something most people never notice. So I'm actually... somebody's talking to me. Zeus, invite please. Sorry, not playing right now. Right now, just training Vanarai. But we'll talk in a little bit. Alright, so that's about feeding the air. So yeah, as I said, feeding the air has a limitation that you cannot wall eject, but it has that that advantage. And the advantage becomes really obvious when the person who you're going to grab kill has a smoke bomb. Because if they have smoke bomb and you are going into feed on the wall, you have to wait a little bit, and thus they'll have enough time for deploying the smoke bomb. Whereas if it's feeding the air, it is fast enough that you can grab kill them before the smoke bomb explodes. So let's do it here. We're going to portray a common scenario that happens in games, and is that your target is on a ledge, and they want to... I would do it. And they want to use smoke bomb to defend against the grab kill. This is pretty common, because smoke bomb is the only ability that can save you from a grab kill. So put yourself here, for example, and I want you to knife me from here and climb as fast as you can and grab kill me. I'm going to try to simulate a normal reaction from a person who is on the ledge, and I'll deploy the smoke bomb a little bit after you knife me. So let's do that. All right. Oh, well, nah, you knifed me at the wrong place. No, I didn't deploy a smoke bomb, but it wouldn't have worked there. It wouldn't have worked there because you have to wait a little bit. If I had deployed the smoke bomb there, you wouldn't have grab killed me because you have to wait. Well, I'll do it if you want. We can test it in both cases. We can test it in both scenarios. So, for example, this is what I mean. Let's do it here first, because here you can go into feet in the air. Whereas on the other side, you have to go with feet on the wall. Yeah, more or less like that. That's more or less how I'm going to react. But yeah, in this case, I got away because you didn't even move. So let's do it again. No, you took too long. Oh, well, you still grab killed me. Yeah, so this is what I was trying to say. The smoke bomb is not fast enough when it is a feet in the air position. But on a feet on the wall, because you have to wait a little bit so that your character, like... stays tight on the ledge before you get the grab kill, you won't get it. So let's do it here now. Go over here. I want you, well, before you do the knife, because we want to make it realistic, obviously, you're not gonna be here, right? You're not gonna be here. You're gonna be around here, more or less. Like here, put yourself here where I am. When you throw the knife, you're probably gonna be around here. So... yeah, knife me when you're ready. Yeah, so you see? That's the difference. It is not fast enough. Because you're forced to wait. You're forced to wait a little bit on the ledge before you get the grab kill. So the smoke bomb has enough time to get deployed. Whereas on the feet in the air position, it never works. It never works because you have to wait. So now let's do something different. Let's assume that you know I have smoke bomb and that you know that a grab kill is not gonna work. Now you're actually gonna go for the acrobatic kill on the feet on the wall. But the thing is that when it does go for the acro, it's gonna jump on top of me, on top of the ledge, and that is only actually gonna make it worse for you because you're actually gonna get hit by a smoke bomb and you're gonna get on top of the rooftop, and I'll be able to stun you. So it's even worse. So yeah, let's do that. You have to lock me as a target. And yeah. No, you went to the top. You didn't press square. You have to come up pressing square, remember? What I told you basically is... Oh, you did? Why did it go up? That's weird. Alright, so when you're here, and you climb over here, I want you to mash. Alright, let's do it again just in case. I'm not sure why did it put you up top, but it's like you went up normally like this. You didn't like jump on top of me. No, you waited. I think you waited. I'm not sure if did you mash it? You didn't? Okay. Yeah, this happens at times as well, and I actually tested this with some people, that the acro doesn't come out. I'm not sure why it doesn't come out, but either way, even if it did come out, the acro kill where it jumps on top, like you won't kill your target because the smoke bomb will come out and they'll actually stun you. So yeah, let's just try it a few more times to see if I can get you to... Yeah, for example, in this case you went up top and got knocked down. That's something that I... Yeah. Regardless of how it goes, feet on the wall is not... It's just not good enough. You cannot... You won't be able to kill me if I have smoke bomb. Unless you have shield, of course. If you have shield, then you can always react to it. Do you have a set with smoke bomb? Because I wanna do it from my point of view so that people see it from my point of view. So if you have a set with smoke bomb, please switch to it so we can do basically the same thing. Tell me when you're ready. No, well, are you recording? But are you recording right now? Oh, great. Excellent. What do you use for recording, by the way? Okay, Shadowplay? Alright, awesome. That's awesome. Alright, then you'll give me my footage later and I'll put it on. It's bad quality. Oh, that sucks. Alright. Oh, yeah, and my frame rate is also pretty good, so... Alright, all good. Thanks, I'll put a link on my video so that people maybe see it from your point of view, this same session. And I can send you the audio as well, like the commentary audio. If you don't have it, I can send it to you separately, so you can put it into the video. Alright, great. If you already have it, then better. Including my voice, because I don't know if... alright, okay, cool then. Alright, drop smoke bomb after I knife you then. Here we go. Yeah, I can't do anything. Oh, but you're my pursuer. What are you doing, Vanarai? Good job! Well done! Congratulations! Oh, God. Can you move over here? Because over there, I have to be too close to the ledge. So yeah, please move over here for that, for this example, so that I can focus the camera better. Alright, here I go. Yeah, okay, this is what I was talking about. Yeah, this is what I was talking about. You see that I got the aggro and I went on top? This is exactly what I was talking about. This is what's gonna happen if you mash the square button. Let's do it again just for... Yeah. I think you might be getting a little too ahead of yourself with the smoke bomb. It's like you're already predicting that I'm gonna knife you. Your reaction is not being natural. So yeah, react after you get hit by the knife. Don't anticipate it so much. Alright, here we go. Yeah, it's the same anyway. I mean, there's not enough time no matter what. So yeah, you could have stunned me pretty free there. You didn't, but you could have. Anyway, so that's about it when it comes to feet on the wall and feet in the air. Okay, let me show you with the shield that you can always react to it. I mean, of course, in this case, I know you're gonna have smoke bomb, but I mean, in general, it is possible to see the smoke bomb or to hear it in the worst case. So here we go. I'm gonna knife you. Yeah, you can escape regardless. If I have the shield, like, there's not enough time for you to escape. Yeah, you can always do it this way. However, if it is that's only necessary if it's a feet, on the wall. If I knife you in a position that I know is feet in the air, I mean, I won't activate the shield, even if I see you drop the smoke bomb, because I know it's not gonna be fast enough. I know I'm gonna get you even without the shield, so I'm gonna save an ability there. And by the way, this is normally how you should use shield against smoke bomb. You should always try to use shield reacting. No, and not just with smoke bomb, by the way. Also with time phase. If there is an ability that you cannot react to, then you shouldn't use shield against that ability. A great example is Firecrackers. Firecrackers is instantaneous, so you cannot react to it. You can anticipate it, but that is precisely the problem. The moment that you have to start anticipating other people's abilities in order to counter them with shield, then your shield is going to start being less effective, because there will be a lot of times that they don't even have the ability, but you activate the shield in anticipation, and that's no good, because you're trading a shield for nothing. And the whole point of shield is to trade in advantage, to generate advantages for you, you know? To make them waste something. If they don't waste anything, then your shield is at a loss. It's like if you hadn't used anything at all. And that is the thing. Like, you in AC, your objective as a player should be to create small advantages every time you do something. And these small advantages in the long term are going to translate in giving you the win. Because each small advantage is going to sum up and you're going to end up winning, basically. Ideally, you should be in the lead the whole game, or from the start, not get it at the end of the game. Some people playstyle is oriented so that you will start by losing and then you'll land a score times two or something of the sort to get the win. But personally, it's not the style that I use. And there's a reason for it, is that you cannot ensure that by any means you'll be able to get a good kill with times two against good players. That is precisely the main fault of that strategy. I mean, it is great against noobs, because against noobs you can always get a good kill at any point in the game. But with good players, that is not the case. Good players will often be difficult to kill, and it is almost impossible to predict when will you be able to get a good kill. Because, you can get good kills on good players, but it's not something you can guarantee most of the time. It just happens that in some cases you see an opportunity and you take it. You see an opening and you take it. But how can you guarantee that you will see a given opening at a given moment in time in the game? That just doesn't work. So what you have to try to do is always have the lead and increase your lead as much as you can with the little details that go as the game progresses, like getting a hidden, getting a variety, getting a streak, getting a trip 50. Yeah, that's kind of like small advantages. And then, unless you're in the lobby. All right, obviously there are other concepts which I am not discussing here. Obviously you don't always go for an advantage, or the type of advantage that you're trying to create is not exactly in terms of points. Sometimes the advantage that you're trying to create is in terms of time. When the time is about to end, it doesn't matter how many points you have, as long as you're in the lead. Winning by 100 points is as good as winning by 50,000 points, because a win is a win. So, obviously, ideally, you want to score as much as you can so that there's less risk of losing at the end. Like, you don't want anyone to just suddenly beat you at the last second, so obviously you want to have as many points as possible. But when the time ends, if you win by 50 points, it's as good as winning by 1,000 points, or as good as... Yeah, this is a mistake people often make. The objective of Assassin's Creed as a game is not to score as high as you can, it's to score higher than your opponents. That is the objective of the game. That is how you win. So, for example, you're not trying to score a 10k or anything like that. I mean, it's cool and it is rewarding to do so, but it is not the objective of the game. And if you train yourself to be good at scoring high, or at scoring, I don't know, like if you make your objective to score high, to score 10k, then what's gonna happen is that when you face players who use pressure as their strategy, or who use streak-based styles, you're gonna notice that you're falling behind and you're just not fast enough. You know, you're gonna notice that you're gonna get poached a lot, and that basically you're gonna start complaining like, oh, these guys, they run so much. But yeah, actually it is you who is slow. It's not that the others are, they're not running like desperately or anything. No, they know what they're doing. They're just taking advantage of the fact that you're too slow. I mean, if you have an opponent and you know they have a weakness, What are you going to do? Obviously exploit it. That's what you're gonna do. If I know that Vanarai as a player only knows how to get slow kills, or that she always wants to get a 700 point kill or a hidden kill, what am I gonna do? I'm always gonna stay away from hidden groups. I'm always gonna stay away from you. I'm gonna run because you're afraid to kill me for 100 points or for 150. So I'm just gonna run away from you because that always works. Now, if you pressure me and you start killing me for 100 points, 150 points, I'm gonna have to slow down because obviously dying isn't gonna work for me. I'm gonna be forced into hiding. Yeah, so that's kind of how it works. I mean, slow pace, fast pace, there's a reason for each. And for example, if you're winning, this is something that many people do not understand. When you are in the lead, it should be your objective to apply as much pressure as possible to the people who are not in the lead, because you're already winning and all you have to do is ensure that the others do not score as much. Obviously you want to score as much yourself, but if you can, for example, let's say that you have 1,000 points in the lead and the guy who's behind you, like he's your target, are you going to go for a good kill or a rush kill? You should go for a rush kill, because he's in second, and if you let him get points, then it might not be good for you. However, it is all about point differential. You can let your target get a kill as long as you get more points than they do. So for example, if they get a, I don't know, if you pressure them and they get a 300 point kill and you get a 700 point kill, that's still good enough because you're getting more than them. That is the whole point. If you get a 150 point kill and they don't get any kill, you still get more than them. So it's still good for you. You're creating an advantage. Now, when it is not good, is when you get a 150 point kill and they get a 700 point kill. That is not good. Because in the long run, if you keep doing this, they're gonna catch up to you and you're gonna lose. Yeah, stop doing that. oh my god. Stop being silly. how do you go through me? That's not possible. Alright. Yeah, we actually have to do something like, yeah, yeah, let me put myself on top of you. Yeah, yeah. Like this, like this. Stop looking at my bee. Stop looking. No. Alright. So, yeah. That's when it comes about that. That was just general guidelines for and strategy. Obviously, that doesn't have to do much with acrobatics. But we did already cover everything there is to cover about basic acrobatics, in terms of the instant drops and the two grab kill positions. So yeah, in the next delivery we're gonna talk. Oh, forget that. Your OSB is not gonna hit me. I shielded it. So yeah, that's more or less it. You have to adapt to your opponent's strategies. Run when you gotta run. Walk when you gotta walk. There's a moment for everything. By the way, when you are losing, that is the moment for walking. That is the right moment for walking. Unless your target is the guy in first. I mean, if the guy in first is your target, then you might have to choose between a rush kill and a silent kill. But in general, you can get either. And it is okay, because as long as you kill the guy in the lead, he's not gonna be making points and you can catch up to him. But if it's someone else, if your target is not the person in the lead, then you should definitely try to go for as many points as you can. Because the whole point of the thing is to get the lead. Get the lead. That is your objective. To win.